with the Chuck E. Cheese and I was in the hospital emergency room with skid marks all over my body and could not fucking move when my daughter was turning 5.
Oh, I missed that. I'm sorry.
Mm-hmm.
My bad.
That's why when I call my mama and be like, Mama, I can't move, my mama be like, damn. She be like, let that play out again. I be like, yep.
Persona. So what do you mix with?
A white Indian and black.
White Indian, black. What tribe? What Indian tribe?
I'm mixed with the Moa.
Well, I got black.
Geronimo?
Yeah.
The Indian Geronimo is my ancestor. That's proven fact.
You said Kunta Kinte.
The Indian Fumo?
Oh, Fumo? Mm-hmm. I'm listening. Hello? Hello?
Huh?
Okay, there you are.
I said, you know Geronimo?
Yeah.
The Indian, okay, he's my ancestor.
Oh, he?
And that's true respect. I have, biologically, it's true respect. Through my mother's side. Now, my father's side, fact, I don't know nothing about his side, because they didn't give me no paperwork on him. But on my mother's side, I'm originally a Weaver. My last name is Weaver.
Oh.
And I'm kin to Weavers, Reeves, Snows, and Burrs, and those are all Moa. Indian, like, ancestors, like, cousins from Moa tribe. It's what they call white cat, Cajun. What they like to call Cajuns because they're mixed with Indian.
This motherfucker won't let me get no motherfucking words on.
They're
she
calling them Caucasians, they just call them Cajuns.
But you want to know me? How the fuck you going to know me if you going to keep talking and don't ever let me get no words in?
Like
look.
A pure white,
she don't even know she on me.
But they're mixed. You know what I'm saying? With Indian.
Yep. Well, I come from the Blackfoot Indian tribe. My grandmother, Blackfoot Indian. So...
Okay.
If you know anything about Blackfoot.
That's what's up.
Look, something's in my eye. Oh, my goodness. So.
You wouldn't hear that much about the Blackfoot tribe. But you do hear of, the tribe.
Yeah, it's a real small, it's not, yeah. You know, yeah.
It was a very small tribe, you know, back in the, yeah. It wasn't as large as the Moa tribe. But they killed a lot of my ancestors off. But I still want to ask the government, hey, okay, my dad is black, so can I get my 40 acres in a mural? My mama is Indian, so can I get my house built on that 40 acres in a mural? Because, okay, y'all promised the white man promised the black 40 acres in a mural in the Constitution and stuff, but we still haven't fought for it. And then the Indians, they fought for theirs. They got, you know, like Indian reservation where the whole town is everything but Indians. Like, if I can actually go live on a reservation, but who wants to go do that?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So can I just get my house just, like, booked on my 40 acres? Instead of a mirror, can I get a car?
For real. Yeah, real talk, though.
Nigga want a motherfucking Mercedes, bitch. 2014. Actually, 2015, 16 Mercedes. Can I get one of them? They ain't even came out yet. or a Lamborghini, something. Can I just get something?
Something.
You know? But, yeah, if you have, like, if you have documentation, actually, even you, if you have documentation that you are either, I think, 10 or 15.
No, it's 30. Indian. It's 30%. You have to be 30%.
30% Indian. Mm-hmm. Okay, well, I was...
All I have to do is get my grandmother's birth certificate. However, she has, she you know, deceased in 2012, 3 days before my birthday, on the 20th, as a matter of fact. And so I have to get those documentation. Because I can get my school loans and all that paid off.
See, I know, me too. I get that paid off just because I'm disabled, though.
You get all your school loans paid off because you're disabled?
Mm-hmm. You know, you get your student loan. I just recently found that out, too. That's why I'm going back to school for my business degree. Because they was like, don't you know, afterwards, like, you're disabled. You know, like, they have to pay for your school. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're disabled. Mm. I was like, wow, really? Let me call you.
Okay, why is this cubby rolling on my bed? I'm gonna sit on this ass. Somewhere between psychotic and iconic. Somewhere between I want it and I got it. Somewhere between I'm sober and I'm lifted. Somewhere between a mistress and commitment, but I stand down. Girl, I always stand down.
I'm sorry, my music came on loud. What'd you say?
I said, what's your favorite color?
Red.
Mm.
I look good in red.
I should have known, because that's mostly all Aries' favorite color.
Fire.
I know, right? Oh, wow. Nice. I like that. So what does fire represent to you?
Hot-headed, fully energized. Definitely adventurous, spontaneous, combustible. Endure destruction. Because,
okay,
you know, we can destruct some shit. You know, we'll let a motherfucker pounce on us for only so long. And then we're going to rest the...
We'll take so much shit, but then it's going to be problems. We got to do it out. Like, okay, bitch, you got, like, a fair share of fuse with right now. I've been taking this shit for, like, 2-3 months now. You need to just cut it out. But fire represents to me strength, uniqueness, power, a force. It also represents energy, and beauty. That's what fire represents to me.
Right on.
Get your little ass over here with your brother. Don't be out trying to come over here with me. And who's not going to be sleeping on the foot of the bed and we got a motherfucking big ass queen size over here? And y'all ain't nothing but a goddamn big as my hand and your mama ain't as tall as my fucking calf. I be laying in my bed and these motherfuckers be like right on me, bro. Rocks be right up underneath me. My ass be on the end of the damn bed and I wake up, all the extra space on their side be just a freak. I be mad.
Yeah.
I be trying to tell her she's the wrong species, but she don't believe me. She just be wanting to cuddle. She's a big old baby.
So tell me something else about you that you think I should know.
Let me see. Let me see. I am the baby of my siblings. I'm also spoiled. Pick up off of a line with the Aries sign, though. We spoiled, but we also very spoiled.
Already.
We like to be spoiled.
And we can but also stand on our own. I hope you never watch this video because I am straight talking shit about you while you on the phone.
You don't even, like, I've raised my kids, like, I've only been here 4 years and I talk to my kids every day. But I left Mobile when they were like 5 or 6. Well,
clearly, I can run over her. This is going to be another EJ situation. I can't fuck with her because I already know I can run over her.
And my sister,
I need somebody that
like, I'm still the baby.
I cannot run over. Real talk.
I can't have no kids.
Real talk.
I need to be free type shit.